children, how are you all today? I hope you all are fit and fine. For today's English lesson, we are going to continue with the nouns chapter from your mastering grammar book. Children, last day, that means in our first video lesson, we had discussed about what nouns are and how they are used or how we can identify them in sentences. Right, children? And now, today for this class, we will be continuing with the kinds of nouns that we were studying in that video. Okay, children? So, we had learned about two of the kinds of nouns, the common and the proper nouns. And what did I tell you about the three other nouns? I told you they are collective noun, material noun, and abstract noun. Right, children? So, now let's move ahead with the other parts and learn about them in great detail, and I welcome you all to your English class once again. Children, now you can see that after we have finished the proper nouns, you should also remember what I did not tell you in that video about common and proper nouns, that common nouns do not use capital letter in the beginning. That means you won't be starting a common noun, you won't be capitalizing the first letter of the common noun. But for proper noun, you will have to use the first letter as capital. Means you have to capitalize the first letter. Okay, children? So now let's move to the next one. With in the following page, on page number 12, you can see that we have an exercise to do. So what could be better than doing an exercise just in the very beginning of the lesson? So children, please be ready with your book, and so there you have page number 12b. Circle the proper nouns and underline the common nouns. Okay, children, let's do that. So read the instruction very carefully. Always remember, whenever you are asked to solve an exercise or you are required to answer questions, you have to number it really properly. So B, and you have to read the instruction as well. You have to circle the proper noun and underline the proper nouns. So we are here on B and not A, because A we have already done in our previous video lesson. Rajiv and Priyanka are brothers and sisters. Starting with number one, Rajiv and Priyanka are brothers and sisters. Okay, children, so Rajiv and Priyanka are brothers and sisters. Now can you tell me what is Rajiv and Priyanka? Aren't they names of people? So what did I tell you for names? I told you that name of a person or of place or of a or an object, like if you're keeping a proper name, so that will be a proper noun. So children, here we have Rajiv. So we were required to circle them. We don't need to write it, because we were required to circle the proper noun. Let's circle Rajiv and let's circle Priyanka also, because these are common nouns. Now children, you can see we have other nouns as well in the sentence. So brothers and sisters. Sisters, brothers. So are they name given to particular person? No. Okay. What do we see there? All brothers generally are called brothers only. Like your brother, my brother, in common language, in common term, we call them what? We call them brothers only and sisters only. So children, here we have brothers and sister underlined because they are common nouns. Okay, children, now moving to number two. The capital of Nepal is Kathmandu. So first of all, children, please find out the nouns for me, so that when I come back to you with the answer, you can say, ma'am, I knew this. So the capital of Nepal is Kathmandu. Okay, so children, are you ready with your nouns? Okay, so let me spot it for you. Capital, Nepal and Kathmandu. So children, for, you know, if you are observant enough, if you observe properly, you will note that I told you for proper nouns we use capital letters. So you won't be having a problem identifying a capital noun or a common noun. Because for common nouns never start with a capital letter. So children, see which things you can see in capital, Nepal and Kathmandu. So Nepal is a name of a place, Kathmandu is a name of a place. With name of places, I told you that they will be definitely proper nouns. Right children? So now let's go and circle the proper nouns and then underline the common noun. Yes children? So now let's move to number 3. Othello was written by William Shakespeare. Othello was written by, yes children, this is a very famous play by Shakespeare. So Othello was written by William Shakespeare. I hope you have heard this man's name before, because he is not an ordinary name in the field of literature. People know literature by his name also. So because he was such an efficient, such a remarkable playwright, dramatist. Okay. Now children, let's move to number 4. And before moving to number 4, let's do this one first. So I told you proper nouns will be starting with a capital letter. Othello is a name of a play. So for that reason, this has to be what? Yes children, this has to be a proper noun. Okay children. And now obviously William Shakespeare, I told you he was a playwright. So this is also a proper noun because it is name of a person. Okay, so now I have circled it, it's very clear because we have been told to circle proper nouns. So I did not need to write it, but for better understanding, for making you understand the nouns, the kind of nouns that these are, that's why I wrote it down. So number 4 children, now let's move to number 4. Teachers and students worked together for the exhibition. Again, the same rule you will have to follow. Please spot the nouns for me. Teachers and students worked together for the exhibition. Okay children, so although teachers have started with capital letter, it has started in this manner because I told you in sentences chapter that all sentences start with a capital letter. Don't think that ma'am has told us that proper noun will be in capital letter. That's why here teachers is in capital. Teachers T is in capital. So children, teacher, anyone, I told you about this word, I think, when I was teaching in our first video lesson of this chapter, that teacher or any other profession, okay, that has to come in common noun because it is not talking about a particular teacher, but about all the teachers in general, about any teacher in general. So a teacher, either me or any other teacher, would be called a teacher only. So that is a commonly used term. So children, this cannot be a proper noun, it has to be a common noun. Also children, I'm not taking any name for the student, I'm just using the word students. So this has to be a common one. Now work together for the exhibition. Here you see exhibition is the word. Exhibition is also a common noun. It is a name given to an event which exhibits, that means which puts everything on display, like the especially like paintings exhibition or flower arrangement exhibition. Okay children, so that exhibition, so it is also a common noun, and that's why I have underlined that word. Now children, moving to number 5. The poem Ode to Autumn was written by John Keats. Yes children, you should read this poem. Obviously in your senior classes you will be reading this poem, and it's a beautiful composition by John Keats. So let's write down this question. The poem Ode to Autumn was written by John Keats. Children, were you able to first spot the nouns? First you have to do that task only, then only we are going towards identifying the type of noun. So here the word poem, you can see this is a noun. Then we have Ode to Autumn, because it is a name of a work by John Keats, and also John Keats is a name of a person. So children, this one is a proper noun, this is the name of a person. John Keats was a famous writer, poet, dramatist. Okay, he is mainly known for his poem only. So now number 6. Children, see this one, poem is a common noun, ode is a name of a work, that's why this is a proper noun. You won't categorize it as a common noun because it is not a common noun and it is a name of a work. Okay, it is not talking about all the writings or all the pieces of work of John Keats, but only one, Ode to Autumn. So it is specifying, it is using the particular example, or it is giving the particular name of the work. That's why that is a proper noun. Okay children, now moving to number 6. Happy Feet is an entertaining movie. Okay, so Happy Feet is an entertaining movie. So Happy Feet is the name of a movie. So obviously, because I told you name of particular things or of particular person has to be proper noun. So this is, children, our proper noun, and is an entertaining movie. So Happy Feet is a particular movie, and movie, we know movies are lot, there are lots of movies, just not one. This Happy Feet is just not one movie. So the word movie is our common noun, so that will be underlined, children. Okay, now let's move to number 7. This is the last question of this exercise. Mother washes Ritu's clothes in the washing machine. Okay, let's see, let's write this sentence first. So mother, the circle is really larger one, so let's make it smaller. So mother washes Ritu's clothes. Ritu's clothes in the washing machine. So children, with some words, I will tell you to be really, really careful, because you might have heard the term washing for verb, as verb, right? But you should also remember that in some sentences, when we can use it as a noun also, when we are combining, or when we are combining it with a noun, like it can be used like a compound noun. Okay, children, so you should remember this. Now let's see. Mother, children, your mother is a mother. My mother is a mother. So all mothers are called mothers only. So children, what did I tell you? When we do not specify a particular person or thing or an object or anything else. So this will be a common noun. That's why I'm underlining it. Washes is the verb here, so obviously it's not a noun. Ritu's clothes. Now children, Ritu is a name. Okay, clothes, all clothes, like whatever I am wearing, what you wear are called clothes only. I am not wearing any different kind unless I name this one. Unless I name, my clothes orangey, okay. So, till then, all clothes are clothes. That's why clothes are common nouns, okay. And now moving to this last one, this washing machine. It is used together, children, right? So you shouldn't consider this washing as a verb, because verb is here, washes. And that washing machine is a machine. So it's the name given to the machine, not a particular washing machine, because it's not that the machine that you will be having, like the washing machine you will be having, no one else in this world have. So there are numbers and several washing machines in the world built daily on daily basis, right, children? So yes, washing machine is also our common noun. With this, we have finished the B exercise. I hope you understood my explanation why some words are common nouns and why the other words are proper nouns. Okay, children? Now let's move to the next kind of sentence, that is our collective noun. Now children, sometimes what happens for nouns, we group them, okay? Because I can't constantly keep telling that two cows, three cows, four cows, when there are many, right? So for that, we name the group or collection of those nouns, containing those nouns, so that it is easier for us to comprehend the meaning of the sentence or the group, classify the group. Because with use of such words, our sentence construction or the sentence framing becomes much easier. Okay, children, I hope you understood what I was trying to say. So now let's move to the definition of collective nouns. Let's write it down. Okay, so you have your definition in the book, children, but obviously, I'll be writing it down because some of you question a lot that, ma'am, do we have to write it in the copy? Do we have to write it in our notebook? So, yes, children, let's write down this one as well. So, collective noun. This one is the third kind that we are learning. So, let me mark it as this three Roman numeral. So, collective noun. What does that mean? Nouns that name a group or a class of similar thing. Nouns that name a group or a class of similar things or person taken together. Collective nouns. Yes, children, so with this definition, I hope I cleared what are collective nouns. Now let us look at some examples so that the definition comes to life. Okay, so the examples can be army. You know, in an army there are a number of soldiers. So army can be of anything, not only soldiers. I can use this for ants as well, because they are always in a cluster, they are always marching like soldiers. So we use army word for them also. Okay children, so you have other words as well. Herd is a very common word used for a group of buffaloes or for cows. Okay, elephants also, they are also called herd only. Their numbers of elephants together are called herds, herd. Okay, next we have fleet. The word fleet, when you see a lot of ships sailing together, when they are in or in the harbor, so they, it is called fleet of ships. Ships, okay children, fleet of ships. So now let's move to the next word, bunch, pack. You have a lot of it. I think you remember we did this one in your how did the dog found its master, right children? I think we did in that chapter only. Please correct me or just ignore this if I'm missing the chapter. I think we did it there only in that chapter, these things, in the how the dog found himself a new master. So now we have some common features of nouns. Collective nouns are treated as single units. You should remember children, this is not a plural. If I'm talking about a class of students, then I have to use a singular verb. I cannot say the class of students are. I have to use is or was if it is in past tense. So children, the verb has to agree with the subject. Here our subject, if the subject is a collective noun, you have to use a singular verb. Do remember this children, okay? So with collective nouns, you are always going to use singular verb. They are naming words for animals, things, persons and places taken together. So we know nouns are actually names of people or person, thing, animals, places. Similarly here, collective nouns are considered the group of those names of people, okay? So now, flock of sheep, a suite of rooms. So suite, yes children, that is sweet, not that mishti wala sweet, but instead it is sweet, referring to rooms, collection of rooms. Okay, beautiful decorated lavish rooms are called suite of rooms. Okay children, now let's move to the next one. Some more examples of collective nouns are a fleet of ships, a bunch of keys, a pack of dogs and an army of soldiers. Okay children, so you have, do not think that the nouns are collective nouns. Instead, for those group of nouns, for the collection of those nouns, we are using that collective noun. Okay children, now see here, we have some more examples. Like, you have to learn this children, because sometimes I know that you get a little bit confused. So yes, a pack of cards, dogs, wolves. So you can use a pack for which nouns? Like for cards, okay, for dogs, for wolves, because dogs and wolves, you know, we have learned in the chapter in how the dog found himself a new master. We had learned there that wolves and dogs are similar because of their appearance. Maybe a suite of rooms, a team of players. So the word team is our collective noun here. A school of fish, yes, not this school, but a school of fish is because they are very much organized, okay, that's why we are calling them school of fish. Swarm of bees, you must know the honeybees. So the collective term for a lot of bees together is a swarm, okay. A crew of sailors, even flight attendants, okay, those who fly in planes or those who are there present attending us in the flights, in the planes, so they are also called crew. And sailors, okay, the one who are regular professionals in a ship, okay, so they are the sailors. A bunch of bouquet of flowers, so you know, like I'm gifting a bouquet to my friend, so they are usually a bunch of flowers, collective used for flowers. Then a mob of people, mob, M-O-B is for a group of crowd, actually for a crowd, right? A mob refers to the crowd of people. Now moving to the next one, a flock of birds or sheep, okay? A bunch of bananas, grapes, flowers. Then a herd of cattle or deer. And then a litter of puppies. Okay, you can see so many words, so many collective nouns are there. And still when I ask you in your classes, you are still so much puzzled, ma'am, you don't know, we are confused and all. So a cabinet of ministers. Yes, children, cabinet refers to the important ministers. So they have a group of ministers holding important positions. So a cabinet of ministers, okay? A clump of trees. When you see a lot of trees, from now on, you're not going to say that there are many trees. From now on, because your English teacher has taught you, you are going to say what? That there is a clump of trees, like there are lots of trees lined up together or in a cluster. A cluster of huts. Okay, so I said the word cluster and it's right here. For huts, children, you are going to use cluster. The word, the collective noun for huts is cluster. A squadron of aeroplanes. So yes, you might have heard the rank of officers in those who are pilots or those who are in Air Force. This term squadron leader, like this thing. So when we are talking about the aeroplanes, okay, yes, I think I remember the word. It was hangar. Yes, so the place where lots of aeroplanes are lined up or they are kept when they are not flying, that place is called hangar. So this word was not striking my mind, but yes, at least better late than never, right? Okay, a shoal of fish. Okay, children, see, we had studied about another word here. Now it's shoal and not school. So school is usually referred to the young fish. Okay, those fish which are young, which are new, they have just taken birth. So school word is used for them. For the adult ones, for the for a bigger variety of fish, we say what? We say shoal of fish. Now a library of books. Yes, because where will you find so many books? Wherever you see that books are stacked up, they are kept in a larger quantity, then you understand, larger number, then you understand, or then you can say that she has a library of books. That means she has a lot of books. Okay, children, so I hope you understood this collective noun. And now, children, with this, we have an exercise to do. After that, we will be wrapping up our lesson. Match the words in column A with appropriate words in column B. So, children, what do we have in column A? Okay, let's see, let's write it down. A, number one, a fleet of. I had told you about fleet, that this word, this collective noun is used for ships. Also, it can be used for some other nouns as well. Like from this group, we have luxury cars. So B side, I'm writing it here and I'm just writing the answer beside this one. So luxury cars will be your answer for number one. Okay, children, now number two. An orchid, okay. So children, wherever we plant fruits or vegetables, that vegetables, those places are known as orchid, okay? So an orchid of fruit trees. Yes, now moving to the third one. A crowd. Okay, let's write that down. A crowd. A crowd of people. Number four, an army. An army. So an army is for of soldiers. Army of soldiers, right, children? So we have it here. Now number five. A library. So a library of books. Of books. Number six now, children. A sweet. A suite of rooms. So children, here is our C exercise, you can see. Okay, so we are done with today's lesson, children. I hope you revise, you go and watch the previous video also and revise what we have learned and prepare yourself well for the other video lesson that is about to follow. We will meet again in our next video lesson, children. Till then, please take care of yourself and your family. Bye-bye.